Your favorite trainer's favorite trainer. It's your man, 100 Grand Mike Trotter, and I am the PT Boss, your favorite trainer's favorite trainer. And today, we got a good one for you because I'm with my man, Tyler Ramsey, right?
Yes, sir.
And we are here at Titan Fitness, which is a strongman facility. And y'all know that's a little bit out of my element, but that's what we're going to do for the next few weeks. We're going to try to find some things that's a little bit outside of my comfort zone. So Tyler's going to tell us what we got today. So Tyler, what do we got today, big fella?
So we are gonna start right over here with the log press. So this log is 120 pounds by itself. So
without nothing on it?
Nothing on it, just by itself it's 120 pounds.
Okay.
So you're basically going to do a deadlift from the floor.
Okay.
And then like a clean up to your shoulders and then a shoulder press from there.
Okay.
So we will tilt the handles forward. So our shoulders look apart, arms straight. We're gonna deadlift it up to our lap. And we're gonna squat down. Then we're gonna use our hips on our shoulders and then press it above our head. Then you can jump
it
down on the mats.
Okay, cool. We going in right now, or he gonna take me through each one?
We just hop right in and then we'll have him explain the next one.
Oh, okay, well, shit. All right. Y'all don't warm up around here, huh? It's just, all right, cool. Maybe I should do a 20. So you said deadlift it from the ground. 20,
yep, so straight 10. Up. Maybe I should break a 10, do a 5. Yep, and then from there, you're going to have your elbows nice and high. Yep, squat down. Yep, take up your chest on it right there, yep. And then from there, you're going to take a big breath in. You're going to roll it up your chest. Yep, take your elbows as high as you can, yep. Yep, and then, yep, good. You can control it down to your shoulders, yep. And then you can clean it each time, or if you want to stay right up at your shoulders, you can dip and drive.
Each time, so we gotta do multiple of these?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's like once I get it up there, now I'm pressing it.
Yep. Elbows nice and high. Then drive those elbows up, under. Yep. Yep. Good. Yep. Turns into cardio after a while.
After a while, I'm already feeling it. Damn, I thought you was just gonna talk us through us, but we jump right in. Okay, cool.
We jump right in.
Cool, all right.
You handled it well.
All right.
You handled it
well.
He
looked like a natural.
My goodness.
You might as well just start competing with me.
See how this goes?
You're gonna catch me, man. There's only one way.
All right, so we're gonna move on to the yoke carry. Usually this is for distance and for speed. So it's usually really, really heavy, but you gotta be able to run really fast with it. And then usually in a competition, it's timed, so the fastest time usually wins.
Okay.
So, usually what you do is you put your hands here on the sides. That's gonna create it from not shifting side to side.
Okay?
So get your upper back nice and tight. We're gonna go about shoulder width apart. You're gonna take a big breath in, eyes up, and you're gonna drive your hips straight through.
Okay.
And then from there, you're gonna just take nice steps. Try to go as fast as you can. Down to the line.
First time I ever did this, I looked like I was drunk walking.
Yeah, he was like,
I was all over the place.
It's probably gonna be good. Are we going right in?
You take whatever breath you need, man.
That's a
difference.
So you don't look as drunk as I did the first time I did it.
Shit, feel like it.
Steps. There you go. Short breaths. Short, choppy breaths. Yep, turn your run kale over.
Fuck.
There you go.
Alright, that was a big difference there. Shit. What's the, so you say I do this for time, right?
It's usually for distance, fastest time.
Gotcha. So what's the typical distance? Like at a...
Usually like 50 feet.
Okay. And what's the typical time for that? Like a good time?
Usually anything under about 15.
Seconds?
Yes. Yes.
So 50 feet in 15 seconds?
Yeah.
With that weight on your back?
What was nationals? What was
next year for nationals? I have to do 50 feet down, 50 feet back, and it's 750.
750 what? Like
750 pounds.
And how much was that?
This is 346.
Yo, I don't even think I would be able to get 750 off the ground.
He picked up 1,000 the other day.
Damn. Okay, Tyler. Okay, Tyler. Cool. All right, what we got next?
So are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Right-handed?
Yeah.
Do you have is it your right arm stronger than the left, or are they pretty even?
My right arm is probably stronger.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because most people, they just pick an arm and they just use that arm.
Okay.
I alternate back and forth. Some days this arm feels better than this arm, so I kind of pick whatever. So we're going to have the middle of our shoes about right in the middle of the handle.
Okay.
And what we're going to do is we're going to go straight down. You can use both hands. And go straight up to your shoulder. Try to get your elbow nice and high, and then the end of the dumbbell is going to sit on your traps, your shoulder, okay? You're going to lean just a little bit to the side, so the circus dumbbell is in the middle of your body.
Gotcha.
You don't want it too far this way, because then you're going to try to press, and it's going to be far away from you. So you're just going to lean just a little bit, and you're just going to use your core a little bit more. And then what I do is I take a big breath in, I dip, and then I drive straight up.
Okay. And then when you, okay,
and then you just
come back down.
Just drop it straight down.
Got it.
And then usually just roll it over here, switch arms, straight up, and then just guide it on the way down. Yep.
Here.
Yep.
I forgot what you said to do next.
Take a big breath in, and then deadlift it up to your shoulder. Yep.
So here?
Yep. Try to get it about right here.
Okay.
Yep, so your elbow's high. Okay, so when you're going to do a small dip with your knees, try to keep this elbow where it is, and then just punch it to the ceiling. Yep. Then bring it back up. Yep. Wind your feet out just a little bit. Yep. Drive through your heels. Yep. Punch. Good.
Yep. Then when I drop this bitch, I just kind of...
Just got it down? Yep. Perfect.
That was wrong.
You want to try your left arm?
All right.
I heard the circus dumbbell crack when he did the first one. The elbows cracking.
Oh, his
everything.
Elbows,
yeah.
I was about to say, that was my elbow.
No, yeah, no. That's like when I did the circus dumbbell for the first time, my elbow cracked like 8 times on the way up.
Definitely my elbow.
Yep. Try to get as comfortable as you can. Obviously, it's going to be a little uncomfortable. Yep. A little dip. Good. Yep. You can use your other hand to get it to your shoulder and guide it.
Yep.
And then once you're ready to press, you gotta take your hand off. Yep. Good. Whoa, punch that baby to the ceiling. Good. Yep, just got it on down. Perfect.
He damn near hits the ceiling.
Yeah. Not how tall enough ceiling for this guy.
Man, I've seen this shit done before, and it looks way easier than it actually is.
The world record.
I'm already
like,
sweating.
The world record's like over 300 pounds in one arm.
Get the fuck out of here.
What do you do?
My best I did this week was 173.
Wow.
With both arms.
Man, that was only what?
68.
See, I think, would you say it's getting the mechanics down?
It's definitely technique.
Yeah.
On these things.
Because it wasn't as heavy as it was awkward.
Yeah, because you could go over there and grab a 60-pound dumbbell and do this all day long.
But it's like at this one, I couldn't find no balance, couldn't find no stability.
Yeah.
So it was different.
Yeah. The training is definitely throwing a lot of stability stuff in, not just the strength stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You got to be able to stable that when it's here and when it's above your head.
Yeah.
So
what happens when, like, okay, let's say I couldn't get that, right? So, like, let's say I get here and I realize I'm fucked. Like, do you just kind of like bail?
You gotta bail.
Yeah?
Yeah. Or you try to catch it with your hand and get it back up there, or throw it down.
So if I got 300 pounds over my head, and I realize that it ain't gonna go over my head, I gotta figure out a way to get out of there safely.
You gotta figure out how to get from here to here with one arm and then get it above your head.
That's a whole level of that danger and fear might add to like the anxiety of completing the lift.
Yeah.
And that probably plays into the success or failure of it, right?
Yeah.
Because now you're thinking about all that shit.
And you have technique too. So you have all those things that are just combined into one lift. And usually in a competition, you have five lifts that are all like this. You gotta be technical in all of them. You gotta be strong. And you gotta be fast.
Respect. See? They shouldn't call y'all just strong, man. It needs something more, you know, a better name that justifies everything that goes into it. Because strong, man, I'm thinking, okay, you go, you just pick the motherfucker up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's more to it than that.
Most definitely.
Respect. Respect.
Time to get stoned.
Okay, let's get stoned, baby.
Okay, so we got, I'm gonna demonstrate on the 175, I'll have you try the 120, and we'll work our way up.
Cool.
Okay? So, we're gonna go just outside the stone. You want the middle of your foot in the middle of the stone, so you're gonna try to cut that baby in half.
Okay?
Then from here, big breath in, try to be the claw. So arms are gonna be completely straight, and you're gonna squeeze it with your forearms. That's why I have my forearms chalked.
Gotcha.
That's gonna help grip the stone when we get under it. Okay? So we're gonna go under, big breath, we're gonna pick straight up, move our feet in, we're gonna get under our lap. Okay?
Got it.
And you're gonna go over the top and try to hug it to you as hard as you can.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there you're gonna do a hip thrust, get it over the top, and then throw it over.
Got it.
Straight up.
Got it. You made that look real easy.
Yep.
I feel official now. It's kind of like, is this the LeBron shit? Or?
Yeah. You want some more so you can do the LeBron?
I don't want to mess your gym up, but I mean. No.
All right. Forward, just a little bit more. There you go. Yep. So right there, right in the middle of the stone.
Okay. Now I go
straight down. With straight arms to your fingertips. You're gonna go under it. Yep. Squeeze it with your forearms, and then lift it straight up. Yep. Yep. Now squat down. Yep. Now go over the top of it with your arms. Yep.
Here.
Yep. And then do that one over the top too. Yep. And now you gotta stand up with it.
But wouldn't it be easier here, or no?
The only reason that I don't want you to do that is because it's going to hurt your biceps, and I don't want you to tear your bicep.
Okay, so how do I get it?
So go. So we're here, go here, and here, and have your hands here.
Got
squeeze
it
as hard as you fucking
got
can,
it.
And then from there, go straight up.
Yep. Got it. Okay.
This one is the slickest, the most smooth one.
Okay.
So that's gonna be.
So what I do about these stars I'm seeing? What they? Y'all don't see them? The stars and nobody sees them but me. All right.
Just you.
Okay, just me. All right. Cool.
Just you.
Okay.
Bottle it up for next time.
All right. It's gonna feel better. All right. So.
Yep.
Here.
Feet are good. I got options. I can pass that. Yep. Just Jackson.
There.
Drive with your legs. Yep. Get your lap. Yep. Hug that dish. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man.
Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. Same old thing, man. You got a fog machine here, or is it just me?
Yeah, it's just you.
Just me, all right.
Just you again.
Just me again. Damn, I feel alone here.
You want to try to pick up the 245? At least just pick it up.
I can't say no, I mean.
You're here. You're in the trenches. You might as well do it.
We here.
Would you like a demonstration?
Yes. I would love a demonstration.
You want it over the bar or to my shoulder?
To the shoulder for sure.
I ain't picking that bitch up over my shoulder, but I would love to see you do it.
You can do the 120 to your shoulder.
Let me see him do it.
I'll throw the 120 up.
Damn.
I can tell you do this a lot. Like, it was no, it was clockwork. ABC. Yeah.
Technique on point. Do it a lot.
And I thrust. What's the transition from?
We'll go to your strong side, to your right side. Yep. So what you're gonna do? Get it here. Tie it tight again, and then you're basically gonna try and follow it up your whole right side. So you're gonna be, try to use your right arm a little bit more.
Pull
it up.
Okay.
And use the sphere, the circle of the stone to kind of just roll it straight up.
Got it. Okay.
Hey, I already said.
Oh, my fault. Flashbacks.
Yep, move your legs in a little bit. There you go, yep. And from there, yep, here. And then just try to roll it straight up and then flip it. Yep, you're right there. Yep, and then hold it and then take your left arm straight out. Be proud to hold it. Flex that baby.
And just put it there?
Yep, and then just go right on the mat. Yep.
Just like that?
Sign me up for the next strong man competition. Yeah. Just kidding, don't do that. I'm not ready. This might be my retirement. As well, my intro and my retirement, same day. No, that's good shit.
That'd be a good thumbnail, that picture you holding the stone on your shoulder.
See, you ain't bad at what you do, brother. That creative mind of yours.
Should we put the big one on top?
Yeah, if you can get it up there for him.
I don't know what's happening, bitch. Put it where?
If I give you the big one, put it on your shoulder.
Wait, if he gets it on his shoulder and we just transfer it.
I don't think, you know, passing me a, what is it, 200 and what?
45.
Yeah. I think we'll just leave it at the 1.
You don't want to play catch with it?
I just feel like handing me that might go not as planned.
Some toes might be messing because I took my shoes off.
You'd be looking at me with such disappointment, like, you couldn't just get that? Nah, Tyler, I couldn't. I could not just get it. Well, that was fun, man. I respect. Had no idea the level of everything that goes into it. It ain't just picking it up and putting it down.
Because some competitions are different. So like you can have the log for max weight. So you have to work up and it could be stupid heavy. Or it could be for reps. So it could be lighter and you have a minute to do as many reps as you can. So you're going for, you know, 8, 10, 12 reps.
Yeah.
So you have to be able to either be strong for the max weight or be conditioned enough to do multiple reps in a minute. Without dying, either way.
So here's my question, based off what you just said, it sounds like it would be safe to say that the strongest guy doesn't necessarily always win.
Correct. So sometimes it's all about strategy too. Because if you win an event, you go last in the next event. So if someone before you only does 2 reps, and you only need to do 3, just do 3 and save some energy for the next one.
Got it, okay. Yeah.
There's a lot of things blowing your whole lot. Yeah.
Gotcha.
A lot of things that go into it. So you gotta think about being strong, being fast, technical, and then kind of where you're placed and using your energy where you need it the most.
Yeah.
So.
Dope. It's strength. It's intelligence. It's strategy. It's technique. I fuck with it. All right. That was it. I mean, I have a whole newfound respect for strongman, and I just want to say thank you to Tyler for putting me through that. Hopefully you guys got something out of it. The goal is to get outside of your comfort zone. There's a lot of different ways to be fit and, you know, do what we do. But I want to end by asking Tyler, what do you have coming up? Any big events, and where can people find you on social media?
I have nationals just next year. I'm kind of taking some time because I kind of hurt my back before this year's nationals. So I'm kind of rehabbing that. And then I'm going to compete in June of next year in Denver for the Strongman Nationals. And then you can find me at Ramsey_strength coach on Instagram.
And where's your gym located?
El Paso, Illinois. Titan Fitness Center. And we're open 24/7. So if you ever want to come get a workout in, just hit me up and you can slide on through.
Dude, thank you for having us today. Hey, this was big.
It was awesome.
Appreciate you, man. You know the drill. If you liked what you saw today, like the video, comment on the video, subscribe to the channel, turn on your notification bell so you can see more content. We'll see you on the next video. PT Boss out. Appreciate you, bro.